Hey, hey, my peeps, Locking Down the Truth with Marci Lock, just enjoying this. And had myself thinking about two things. One, there is no such thing as time. Time is simply a parameter that we've created in our brains and our minds of what, you know, what, how to conform our experiences and what things should look like and the period for things, when the truth is, like, when you experience Einstein time, like I'm experiencing right now, where literally a day feels like a week or more. That it's just, everything is, it's like there's an abundance of time. And this had me thinking about not only the idea that we have for time and why we create a lack of it, because we're in the lack scarcity energy, which means there's never enough time and there's not enough time to do everything and all those things. But on top of this got me thinking about why people are scrambling for time is because they're scrambling for money. And all of what we've created around money. I actually was talking to my good friend Garrett Gunderson, and we were talking about the funny idea that money was created as an amazing, just simple way to create exchange. Instead of the old school bartering system where I had to be like, okay, well, you know, I really want something that from you, but I only have potatoes. And if I only have potatoes and you don't want potatoes, you know, I can't trade to get what I want from you. And so money was created as, you know, not only it's something that portable, so it can be used anywhere, it's something that is unique and different. That means it can't just be duplicated and replicated. Like, there's all these things that are like why money was created, and that's it. It was simply created to be an exchange. And money is just an exchange of energy. And it's actually just recycled energy, because things are just always being exchanged, right? And so, you know, in this, along with these lines, when we think about it, is we've created lack and scarcity. It's man-made, just like fear energy is man-made creation. So if you go to an apple tree and you ask the apple tree, are we in lack? Like, I've heard all this, everyone's talking about lack and scarcity and there's not enough, or there's only so much, or, you know, it's like, if you have it, you're lucky, etc. Bullshit. Is there scarcity? Should I worry that? And the apples are like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I'm gonna keep producing apples. And if you ask the grass, are we in lack or scarcity? It's gonna be like, I'm still producing grass. And when you look around and you realize the sun shines every day with ease, up and down. The grass doesn't struggle to grow. You know, you're sitting here not struggling to breathe. Birds are flying with ease. Creation is happening effortlessly. So it's funny that we've created these ideas and stories around money and what we're able to accept or receive. Someone actually just messaged me this morning and said, hey, are you good at back-end sales, like back-end room sales? And I was like, I'm good at all sales, because I believe in what I sell and I know it's gonna change lives, so I'm good at all sales, and because I know I'm worthy of giving that gift to the world and receiving. And they're like, well, you know, I really wanna break it down for healers and spiritual people in the world that they believe that it's bad. And it's like, well, that's just their own inner shit that they're not worthy. They can't give their gift to the world when they're in scarcity and they can't even feed themselves and they can't help others. But that's all an inner reflection of lack of self-worth. It's not actually about the gift that they have to give. And if they understood the truth, and so there's all these ideas, like, again, about the money that, oh, you know what, if I accept money for my gift, then, you know, it's bad or wrong, or it's not spiritual, or it's not helping people, it's about the money. Those are the ideas and stories and parameters about the money that you created, instead of simply being what it is, an exchange of value. So get this, dollars follow value, or value follows value. So if I'm willing to give to the world value, of course there's something for me to receive. But this is why you see people with the most amazing gifts in the world that aren't giving them to a massive degree, or they're barely sharing them at all, because they can't give it to the world a big degree when their lack of ability to receive, they don't love themselves enough to receive, is missing. And you wonder why the opportunities don't work out, or why it never happens to just get it out to the world. It's because your inability to receive. So all money issues are an inability to receive, just like all these stories and these parameters around money and what it has to look like and how much, or etc., is all your story and parameter. So time is really just the story that you want to make. There's no such parameter or such real thing as time, which we could go deep into. I'll avoid doing that for this purpose. And stick to, and money is simply an exchange of value. So when we drop all the stories and bullshit around you, do you have something to give? And so that, of course, then you have something to receive. It's as simple as that. It's an energy exchange and a value exchange. Everything else is a lie. And so what I'll leave with you is this. is that if we know you're perfect, whole, and complete right now, and you've always been perfect, whole, and complete, you're totally worthy and capable, everything else is a lie. Why wouldn't you be thriving and flying and experiencing everything that you want? It's a good question to ask yourself. This is Marci Lock reminding you, power of choice is yours. Choose your best life. Lock it down.